Now in section 2.5 we will discuss about conductors. We will do some conceptual discussion, and the very first thing is the basic properties regarding the conductors. So some basic properties. We know that materials can be categorized in three main categories, like either a material will be a conductor, a semiconductor, or an insulator. Ideally, there is no ideal conductor or insulator, but it depends on the conduction mechanism that we are having some natural ohmic conductors. So among the basic properties, if we consider a perfect conductor, then it will have an unlimited supply of electrons or charges which will be flowing through it. So there are some properties associated with the conductors. The very first one is that electric field is zero inside a conductor. What does it mean? So it means that the electric field, we will be in a situation in which we are considering only the region or the regime of electrostatics. So electric field will be zero inside a conductor, and as we consider the let's say this is any conducting material. Now this conducting material, the electric field will be zero inside. We know that the net charge in a conductor is equal to zero. This is the net charge. There are charges in the form of atoms. They are neutral. The net charge is equal to zero. So that's why the electric field will be zero inside the conductor. Because electric field means that there will be some charges inside the conductor. And if it would be the situation, then the charges will flow towards the surface. If they will be negative charges, they will be repelling each other and they will go to the surface. Or even if they are positive charges, they will be repelling each other and will reach the surface. So if there would be any electric field, then that electric field will cause disturbance inside this conductor. So electric field is zero inside a conductor. We also know another thing, that a conductor is an equipotential surface. You provide a potential here and that will instantly appear here as well, all over the conductor. So the potential is constant on the conductor, and the constant potential means that the electric field is the negative gradient of V. If V is constant, then electric field must be zero there. And we say that the electric field inside a conductor is zero. The second conceptual thing is that rho is equal to zero inside a conductor. Rho is equal to zero inside a conductor. Now what is rho? Rho we define as the charge per unit volume is defined as rho, the charge density. As we know from Gauss's law that the divergence of E is equal to rho over epsilon naught. When E is equal to zero inside a conductor, then this means that rho is equal to zero inside a conductor. So rho equals zero inside a conductor. And if there would be any volume charge, any net charge, that charge will then flow to the surface of the conductor, and inside the conductor, the charge will be equal to zero. It will reside on the surface. The third conceptual thing is any net charge resides on the surface. Any net charge will reside on the surface. Any net charge resides on the surface. And this thing we discussed earlier as well. That inside it, charge will not remain inside. For example, we are having some positive charges here inside. Then what will happen? This positive charge will be repelling each other, and this cause the charges to flow to the surface of the conductor. And if any charge will be there, any volume charge will be there, then it will go towards the surface of the conductor. So it cannot reside inside a conductor. The dielectric situation is different, but as it's a conducting surface, it's a conductor, so they will very quickly go towards the surface and they cannot reside inside a conductor. The fourth conceptual thing here is that a conductor is in equipotential. A conductor is in equipotential. So this thing we already discussed, that is when we say that E is equal to zero, means E is the negative gradient of V, then when E is equal to zero, then the gradient of V is equal to zero, integrating both sides will give us V equal to constant. So the potential is constant on the conductor, and this will cause that the charges, if there would be, for example, the potential that we provide to one end here, it will instantly appear on the other end as well, and all over the conductor it will be at the same potential, and that will cause the potential to be equal, to be a constant, and that will cause the electric field to be equal to zero, and the surface will be called as equipotential surface. Let's say we consider two points. This is our point 1, and let's say this is point B and this is point A, and we say that these two are having different potentials, like V at A and V at B are different. Then what does it mean? That VB minus VA is not equal to zero. They are not the same. Then we know that VB minus VA is equal to integral from A to B E dot DL. And when E is zero inside the conductor, then it means that this thing cannot be non-zero, but this thing will be equal to zero, and this implies that VB is equal to VA. Both are at the same potential, and such a situation we call is the equipotential, means the potential is the same on both each points. And the fifth one here, that E is perpendicular to the surface just outside the conductor. E is perpendicular to the surface and outside, just outside the conductor. Outside a conductor. Now, what does this mean? When E is equal to zero inside a conductor, but as we go outside the conductor on the surface here, the electric field will be normal to the surface. Here, similarly, here as well, the electric field at any point will be normal to the surface, like here. Similarly, here and here as well. So, the electric field is normal to the surface, and this thing we have already discussed in the normal derivative, that on equipotential surface, let's say this is an equipotential surface, so electric field is zero on this surface, but is I go away from this one, then E is pointing outward and E will be decreasing. It will be decreasing as 1 over R square, like plates of a capacitor. So there is an electric field between the plates of the capacitor, but along the plate E is equal to 0 because it is an equipotential surface and the potential is constant on this surface, and that makes the electric field equal to zero. But perpendicular to this surface, the electric field is there. And it is perpendicular to the surface. And then finally, we are having the issue of induced charges. So let me do it here. Induced charge. Now, for example, we have this conductor, and this conductor is grounded. It's a conducting surface, but we have grounded it, and then any charge that will come on this conductor will flow to the ground, and the conductor, we say that it is grounded and the charge will not reside on this one. But now look at the situation that such a conductor, if I bring another charge here, this is another charge, and this charge, let's say, is a positively charged particle, and I'm bringing it closer to this surface. Now what will happen? On this conductor, I'm having some free charges in this conductor, because conductor, we usually say the 2 to 3 charges are even more per atom are there inside a conductor. They are either free or they are very loosely bound charges. So when I will bring this one closer, then towards the surface, those negative charges will come on the surface. As a whole, this conductor is neutral, but when I move this positive charge close to this one, those negative charges will move here toward the surface, and these charges are basically called induced charges. We have induced them. The charges are not there in reality, but bringing a positive charge closer to that one, an equivalent amount of the opposite charge will come here. Just like in dielectric, we are having the orientation. We are having the orientation of the atom such that it seems like the opposite charge has appeared on the surface. So, this we call is the induced charge, and we will have an always an attractive force between a positively charged particle and the conductor. This will always be attractive because it cannot be repulsive. Induced charge is always the opposite charge of the source one. If this is positive, negative will appear here. If this is negative, positive will appear here. So the force will always be attractive. We can calculate the force as well as the intensity, the as well as the charge density, the surface charge density of the induced charge. So both can be calculated, and with this the conductor portion is complete. And there are some boundary conditions here, but when we will reach the Maxwell equations, then we will cover these boundary conditions, and over there we will derive them. But before the Maxwell equations, I'm just skipping them, not to calculate, but we will calculate it over there after the Maxwell equations.